Hey guys, Hobbs here. I've gotten tons of requests, and my good friend Boogie2988, he started playing this and recommended it as well, to try out Might and Magic Duel of the Champions. It is a card game, and it's free to play, and I do have the link in the description below. And I thought I'd give it a shot. I've been through the tutorial. I did a couple plays against the AI, and also a couple plays against other players as well. And from what I'm finding is it's a unique gameplay, and I'm going to share why. And the thing that I really like too right off the bat is they have championships and stuff. Like, for instance, there's a big one in Paris in November, and so I was reading up on that. So this actually has some, for the competitive player, it's got some in-depth competitive play. What I'm going to do though for this video, I'm going to just show you in the practice versus AI, because that way we can slow it down. So here we go. We're gonna start off with a standard mulligan. If you don't like your hand, you click no, you'll get a new six cards, but this looks pretty good. Right now I'm playing with a standard, like, pre-constructed deck, and from what I see, there's a nice curve. I'll show you more on that later. You both have a hero. Start off with 20 health each. The red is your health, obviously. If you click on your hero, or I'll right click on it, I actually can increase your might, your magic, or your destiny. Or I can draw a card. So with this card, I have those choices. Might, magic, and destiny of two is what I start with. And I have one of the actual resources available right now. Each turn it's gonna go up by one. And right now I have one, he has none. Now with these resources, it's like they don't get used. It's just you have to have that ability cap to cast any of these spells below. So as you see, I can see where my mites are, twos, all twos across, a three, and then it will scale up. So the first thing I either want to do is probably cast, she's a healer, and I think I'm going to cast, I'm going to increase my might by one. So that way I have a choice to cast a few of these. Well, actually I'd have a choice if I had an extra point. I don't have anything. That's basically it. Down here, just to let you know, each player draws a card, but I'd have to cast two of those. And these are different events that they can play. Increase the health of the next creature you deploy this turn by two, but of course he needs three. So turn one was fairly standard. You draw a card every turn. The AI plays super quick, so I can't really explain it until after the fact. Basically, you're looking, and it's very good too, because when you want to fly through some games and practice, you don't have to wait for the AI at all, you know, thinking or pretending to simulate to think. So what you'll see with this hero here is he actually starts with lower stats than I did. So my guy's a little buffed. He's got a little bit more destiny than the other hero. I'm not going to get into any of the faction things right now, but with his other card here, this is your attack damage, how much you punch for, okay? Basically, he summoned it for two. He had to have a minimum of two might, which he had. So it does two attack. Now, this is retaliation. This is like the punch back, but you have to be alive to do the punch back. That's the key. So if something attacks it, this is like having thorns on, but of course you have to be alive to have that go back. So it's like the, you know, if I hit you, you hit me back if you're still up. The other thing too is he has four life. So the thing I like with this, you'll see the life go down as the creature goes. And now for simplicity's sake, I'm going to cast the same creature. Okay, so basically I click on it and I choose where to put it. I can choose to either put it on the back line, this is the back line, or the front line. We'll talk more about these later. They basically have enchantments where you can enchant columns, or these ones you can rows, which is pretty neat. We are going to place this right here for the simple fact. Actually, we're going to place it right there. The flyer, okay, is now blocking because his main goal is to get my life down to zero. My main goal is to get his life down to zero. So as that attacks this way, basically he'd punch me for two, I'd retaliate with one. So, but if I hit him, I hit him for two, he hits me back for one, as long as he's still alive. The great thing about, the reason why I want to choose AI is if I was fighting another player, I wouldn't have been able to talk this long. One thing I have to remember to do is to do one of these three things. I can't draw a card because I didn't save any resources, but I wouldn't want to draw one anyways. Right now I got to get my magic or my might up right now. Destiny's not an issue because I could cast that. But it really looks like we're going to go with the Might right now. And then we should be able to cast everything in our hand once this hits three. That was the first turn, guys. We're going to move on to his turn. Now you'll see his event change. He could pay three, discard a card, then draw a card. So you'll see the AI cast pretty quick. He cast something with Melee Guard, which I totally forgot about, but I do, you'll see where it costs me later in this game. As you see there, he hit me for two, I hit him back for one. Now I do have a Devoted Sister, which actually I can use to heal any character adjacent to her. So what I'm gonna do is, that's the one I'd like to play. Because I don't want this thing to die, even though I'm going to hit it for that. He'll be down to one, but at the beginning of your supply phase. So no, hold on. I'm going to hold that back on that. This thing, I think, will die unless I do move it. If I decide... I'm going to go... Now, this Wild Griffin doesn't have as much health, but he has a little bit more of a punch back. This... I'd like to place right there. I figure I'm gonna lose this guy. So now these two are both down to one health. You think they'd be equal, but no, because he'll be able to attack next turn, mine won't be able to retaliate because it won't be alive in order to do so. He'll probably attack that next turn. Now, here's the thing, if you forget to use your ability, this game's pretty easy at the beginning. It's gonna remind you guys, so don't worry too much. Do you want to perform your hero action? Yes. And based on what we have here, everything's a maximum of three right now. I don't have anything with two might, but I do know I have it in the deck, so I am going to cast that since I can't draw a card. And we're going to end the turn. This is where I get... It looks a lot pretty intense. So he just buffed that creature. Casting. You can attack the turn that it comes into play, just to let you know. So he did kill this one creature off, and he did live because mine didn't do the retroactive feedback, retaliation. Based on that, I can kill this without taking any damage. So that is definitely a no-brainer right there. Then we're going to... The healers are nice because they heal adjacent. Now, see, when I cast this, Devoted Sister, she can only be on this back row. And this guy can only attack basically what's in front of him. So what we'd like to do is put that there. And then what I think I'm going to do is put a blocker in front of her to keep her alive. Because now she's going to heal these two, which, you know, is going to be awesome. And we're going to place her next one, probably next turn there. We want to remember to do our hero card. And we're going to go for more might. At this point, I think we're going to start drawing cards. That's one thing I really like right now. So he casted. We're going to go over the attacks that he did too as well, a few of the cards. I am down to 10 health, which is not good. But you'll see there, I just got healed up, so his attack really meant nothing there. Just go over some stuff that he did. Take a card from your hand, put it face down on top of your library. Heal 2 damage from your hero. So basically, he slowed down his draw by one for next turn, or if he uses an ability. Full health, you're looking at, there's the buff he has, enchant creature permanent. Enchant creature gets plus 2 attack. So this thing is deadly. It's plus 4 right now. 4 with a retaliation of 1. Anything that goes in front of that will get hurt. But what we're going to do is we're going to put something small in front of it. It's going to die, but we want to actually, because we can actually cast both of these now that we have 5, if I put this behind here next turn, she is a shooter, so they can only go on the back row. They are immune to retaliation, so that one will not affect her, but the 4 will. But we want to put a blocker in front. The blocker is at least going to take the damage down a tad. This will always get healed. And now we're going to destroy that. And with this one, we are actually going to take 2 damage from the retaliation. But we're going to do two there. We're down to one. It's going to heal next turn. And hero ability, we're going to increase some magic. And turn on to the next one. I'm hoping you guys are getting a feel for this. I really like the speed, too, that the AI goes. As you get more familiar with the cards, you'll see what happens more often. So this thing is still quite hefty, even after putting that blocker up. This is the main one I really want to get rid of. Otherwise, it's going to keep destroying me. Hit me 4/4. I'm down to 9. He's at 20. Now, I have a Sun Rider available to the cast. This is an interesting one because it is melee, so it goes in the front line. But what happens is when it charges, it also attacks the enemy creatures of the same row of the attack creature. So this counts as only one attack. So basically, that long pole arm is going to do some damage. He's also immune to retaliation. So, you know, and lots of health. This guy, I think I'm going to plop in front here. Obviously, we're going to be able to do some good damage. We can hit him there for 3. Now, if he attacks here to 4, it's going to do 1 damage back. I can't attack this turn that it came into play. Now, we're going to look at the Loyal Griffin. It's going to hit him for 2. It's going to take 1 damage. And it's actually going to get that 1 damage healed next turn. As long as it's not dead. I'm going to cast a second one of these because I can. Throw that there, and next turn should be a good one. I do have to remember to increase something. And this is where getting to know that how you constructed your deck comes into play, because after a while you're going to be like, you know what, if you go heavy into the might or heavy into the magic, which are a lot of spell base, or even heavy into the destiny, you'll know your own deck and how it's constructed. Like, you want to get a peak of 5, you know, 4 and 3. This is a very close game so far. I'm feeling like I am on the losing end, but we might be able to change that around soon, hopefully. It's almost like, I really like, it's like having separate games. Keep in mind, I can move these to a different location, then that will count as a turn if I want to avoid or if I want to change a blocker up. So this guy is about to die. The great thing is when he attacks that, he will not receive any retaliation because he doesn't receive any. And so he'll live, and he's going to take down this monstrosity that we've been working on. And based on his ability, he's also going to deal 2 damage to this next one. So he's a very good go-getter. There we go. We've got that. We want to... Okay, now just to recap, because that didn't go as well as I planned. I thought this guy was going to die. What I forgot to tell you about, guy, was Melee Guard. Okay, what this is this is a melee specific ability that basically it removes 2 from combat damage dealt by melee creatures. That's the key, by melee creatures to this adjacent friendly creature. Basically, so it also removes 2 from the adjacent. So like my healer, which will heal that and this will actually see how it's got +3 and +2. I forgot about that. Now, to solve the problem, now the good thing with that play, I would have attacked anyways. I brought him down by 1. Okay, we would like to get the healer maybe somewhere else so that he's going to die next turn, but we're going to finish that off. It's not going to remove the 3 because it will take it. And in fact, before we do that, we could take this guy down to almost nothing. And as that attacks that, see, no, because it won't be able to retaliate because it's dead. So there's a lot of strategy involved. And I'm just kind of thinking out loud so you guys can see what my plan is. There we go. Now, with this one, we attack. We're going to receive no feedback. We are hitting him for 2, actually. Now, with this being a flyer, it doesn't count as melee damage. It basically just swoop down and kill that guy regardless. So watch this. There we go. He receives his 2. So strategy-wise, kill order is important here, because if we by killing that, this guy loses his debuff at the bottom due to this melee guard or melee guard. You know what? I know that we're going to have paragraphs I like to pronounce it that way. So either way, regardless. So this guy here, he's going to attack this one. He's going to take it down, but he's not going to receive. He's not going to die because remember, he is immune to retaliation. So those two don't matter. Now this guy still serves a purpose because we're going to place a shooter behind him. So it's going to be a blocker for one more turn. This guy's just coming in and getting 2 damage every turn. So we do need some blocker as we are getting low on health. I think I'm going to go with, considering he needs at least 3 damage, I'm going to go with that guy here. So hopefully we can at least kill him. Lastly, I'm going to use this fortune card next turn because basically every time the opponent plays a card, you heal 2 damage from your hero. And speaking of hero, let's get the last... I've got a lot of might and magic and destiny. I'm going to draw a card. Now this is a cyclone card, cast 4 to cost, you need 4 magic, so this is a pure magic card, the first one that we've seen. Until your next turn, creatures with the enchanted line can't attack. When cyclone enters the battleground, deal 1 damage to all creatures on the enchanted line. And remember we were talking earlier about enchanted lines, so. These guys are going to be healed, but no biggie next turn. Well, unless he's going to do damage. Most creatures can't attack, so this guy should be solid. So he's... took out this guy. She's still alive, but now she's dead. So we got this line that's open, and we're right down to 8. Every time opponent plays a card, heal 2 damage from your hero. I think I'm going to have to play that. Let's save 2 though and see what we can do first. So 4 resources, 4 magic, but I really only have 3. So I am going to pop that up into 1 more. So now that is castable. And it is an enchantment that the creatures in the line can't attack. And considering my health is so low, the most powerful line right now would be this front line. And not only can they not attack, but considering they got 1 life, they'll be dead. Let's pop that there, save myself 4. And now let's get some life. Until your next turn, every time the opponent plays a card, heal 2 damage from your hero. So we're going to play that. We're not really getting much creatures out. I would like to get that out. The question is, do I get life or block? And this guy would easily take that thing out. Immune to retaliation. Forget that. I forgot about this one. So it's immune. Charge. The only thing it would do is it would block 2 damage, where this would get us a lot more. So we take the 2, and then we get 2 life for every... This is a better play, even though I'm going to just take 2 to the face. Let's get our attacks done. No retaliation, so this is a 3 hit there. We're finally downing his life. This is the moment I like to say is a turnaround time. There we go, we got him down to 15. You know what, I just thought of something. If I want, I can have my cake and eat it too. I can basically cast this for 3, which leaves me with 1, then gets me up to gains 5, which is 6 total. So I'll have 6, and then I can cast the fortune ongoing so that I get my health and I block this guy. Let's do that. I forgot about this fortune instant. So do you want to play this card? Yes. Yeah, so watch this. It's going to go down to 1, then it's going to jump up to 6. There we go. We got 6 resources available. We're going to cast this. It doesn't matter which order it is. We're going to see some healing next turn. So keep your eye on that. And we are going to block. And we're going to put the blocker, I would say with this guy, the retaliation damage doesn't matter. But we're going to put him here. And you know what? That should do. Fantastic turn. Let's see the heals going on as he's playing the cards. There we go, we got 2. Another 2. Now, he didn't put that adjacent, so he wants to block, obviously, his health. But if he put it here, then he would actually buff that one beside him. He played a very much more powerful creature, so I have to keep in mind that it heals 3 at the beginning to from friendly creatures adjacent. So I really got to make sure that if I'm going to kill that, I kill it dead. Otherwise, I'm just wasting my time. Let me see. Or I take this out, which I think is the better play. And look at my life. It went up to 14. Fantastic card that was. And a great play. We kept everything intact. We are going to be able to kill this, and he won't be able to retaliate, which is nice. So let's do that first. Normally, I just go quick. I wouldn't explain it all, but because this is an introduction to it, guys, I'm really hoping you're enjoying this. And that guy, if I want to attack there, he is dead. Let's just see what else I got going on. We're going to make sure that these guys don't attack right there. So if I attack that, I take the retaliation. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move my healer up here. I'm going to cast this so that these guys don't attack. Okay, so I'm not going to attack with this guy this turn. What I think I'm going to do is I'm going to kill this number one. And then I'm going to move. And one thing I forgot about, that guy is going to be healed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, rather than beat my face up against it, I am going to move this down here, which then I can hopefully hit that. It was stupid of me to move that up there, even though I was moving away. Now that guy can't attack. But this is where the game gets interesting. There's a lot of situational abilities, like the enchantments, or I've seen it where you can destroy a full line across here. It's one thing I'm really enjoying about this game. I am going to increase the attack of the next creature you deploy this turn by one. Okay, so if we want some heavy duty attack, but no. Let's draw a card and hope we get lucky here. So melee guard. Throw him there. Now I'm gonna get that same buff this way. So any melee damage, which we shouldn't take any damage next turn, which is awesome. So no health this time when we get cards cast. But he's thrown out some heals himself. So he's back up to 17. The guy threw out heal 2 damage from your hero, heal 3 damage from target creature. So he healed the creature and healed himself. And like I said, it goes quick. As I get more familiar with the game, I know I'll be able to see all that. And the one thing is it's great having a card game go so quick. Speaking of so quick, let's get this thing going. We gotta kill this healer. So deal 6 damage to a target creature. I think it's perfect timing to get rid of that healer. Bam. Bye-bye, healer. So the healer's gone. We've got this row here, which we do have to deal with. Which is interesting is you can still attack with somebody with zero. I'll just show you for example. Now there might be an ability maybe down the road, an enchantment that might still benefit you, but I just like the fact that you can attack with something with zero. So now this is a nice two damage. Two damage. There we go. We're going in nice and quick. Draw a card. See, now this is where the draw power at the end of the game is really neat. I have a second magic shooter, which right now this would be the best spot. Even though they're both healed. Let's go up here. At least she's going to heal somebody. I can always move it later. In fact, speaking of move it later, I should have moved that out of the line of fire. Let's see what happens. He's obviously going to attack me both there. I'm going to lose my healers. Ooh, he wiped me out with an enchantment there. And see those top two? He placed it right there. I'll show you which one it was. Deal 3 damage to all creatures of a target row. So they were gone. Just, he placed it right there in the whole row. Let's see. Deal 3 damage to a target row. So the key is if I wanted to play that and I had a creature here, because see, I can move these once that's your turn. So don't make the mistake I did the first time I used that, is actually cast and wipe out your own creatures, but sometimes there's nothing you can do. It might be the failsafe, right? So we are going to cast this. 3 damage, so we're going to take that out for sure, but not this. Okay, so we're down by 1. Let's draw a card. You'll see I don't got to get the might and magic up because I've got it at the cap of where I want it right now. And she is going to go right here hoping to kill that. But we are down to... There we go, game over. You know, I was so in depth on the tutorial, I didn't realize I had the win. But guys, there we go. I hope you enjoyed that. They do have a lot of statistics. They keep that going. So far, I'm having fun with the game. It is released on PC and iPad. Guys, I do have a link to this game below. It is free to play. You can play the game without having to buy anything. You do have the option if you want to progress faster to purchase as well, just like any free to play. But I would say give it a shot. It's definitely a fun game, and it's got me thinking a little bit differently because of the board placement and the instant placement and enchantments. So far, I'm really enjoying it. I know I'll be playing this on some of my downtime. And thank you very much. It gives me a new game to play. And guys, if you are new to my channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button. That way you'll be the next to be notified. I cover a wide variety of games. I had the privilege today of showing you my first look and a little bit of an introduction, a basic introduction, but it will get you playing, guys. And they do also, speaking of playing, they do have versus AI. They do have, if you just want to hang out with friends, but they also have training where you can actually go through and complete different quests. And that will walk you through a little bit more in depth as well. Guys, thanks again. Till next time.